सदाशिव समारंभाम् शंकराचार्य मध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्य पर्यंताम् वंदे गुरु परंपराम् ओम। पेज 238 वर्स 11। पृथगाभासकूटस्थौ अमुख्यौ तत्र तत्त्ववित् पर्यायेण पृथं तेहम् शब्दं लोके च वैदिके
सेकेंड लाइन प्रयुङ्क्तेऽहम् अपान् ता प्रायुङ्क्ते एकार इज मिस्सिंग यू हैव टू नोट एकार प्रयुङ्क्ते अहम् प्रयुङ्क्तेऽहम् विद्यारण्य analyzing the Brihadaranyaka quotation, in that quotation atmanam chet vijaniyat ahamasmiti purushah. In this statement Vidyaranya is analyzing purushah word or purushah. Here purushah means not a male person. Purayati पुरीशेते इति पुरुषः, द वन हू रिसाइड्स इन द बॉडी इज नोन एज जीवः हियर। पुरुषः मीन्स द इंडिविजुअल। व्हेन ही इज टॉकिंग अबाउट द इंडिविजुअल ही प्रेजेंट्स थ्री कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ दिस जीव द इंडिविजुअल। फर्स्ट कंपोनेंट इज मिक्सचर, ए मिक्सचर इन व्हिच RC and OC both are there. When a person say I am I, what is the meaning? Three meanings Vidyaranya gives. First meaning is Mukhyarthah. Second meaning is Amukhyarthah, number one. Third meaning is amukhyarthaha number two. So mukhyarthaha number one, amukhyarthaha number two, which is number one in amukhyarthaha. Number three is secondary mukhyarthaha. Or we can put in other words, primary meaning is one meaning of the individual. Primary meaning. Secondary meaning, first secondary meaning is the second meaning of this Purusha, the I, the individual. Third secondary meaning, that means second secondary meaning, which is the third meaning of the Jiva. Enough for confusion. Secondary meaning, which is the third meaning of the individual, is called chit. Primary meaning is mixture, chit chidabhasa mixture. Secondary meaning, first secondary meaning is known as chidabhasa, referring to chidabhasa, chidabhasa I. Second secondary meaning referring to chit consciousness. So mixture, chidabhasa and chit. Anyone can be referred to I. Having said this, mudhaihi prayunte, he says, loke mudhaihi prayujyate, he said in that 10th shloka. The mixture is used by the mudhaha, ignorant people. Ignorance of what? Ignorance of one's own nature. What is this one's own nature, and you are showing at your heart and telling every time one's own nature, what you are seeing, what you are experiencing about you is not you. That is not a real you. That is false you, fake. What is not seen, what cannot be experienceable, the invisible, non-experienceable, non-tangible, pure consciousness, existence is your real nature, that is Chit, which is blessing this body-mind complex, which is visible. This body is visible, tangible, gross body, inert body, blessed by the Chit, and tangible body is blessed by the intangible mind, which mind is again inert, which mind is sentient because of Chit. Yesterday Bhagavad Gita class, both are going parallel, you see. That is called blessing, real blessing. Yesterday Bhagavad Gita class exactly coming today. Therefore, primary meaning, secondary meaning number one, secondary meaning number two. So, totally three. But why ignorant people use only mixture? They do not know it is a mixture. When they are interacting, always Chitti is there, Chidabhasa is also there. But Eki Bhuya Prayujyate, they combined both of them, and not knowing they are combining both of them and interact with the world and what? Confusing the people, creating problems, always a delusion. Once you do not know this is a mixture I am using, I am combining both of them and I am interacting, it is pure ignorance. Always ignorant people, wherever they are, problems are galore. Why problems are coming, don't ask. Since ignorance is there, problems definitely comes. For those people, not for other wise people. Other wise people, no, don't take different meaning. Not others who are wise. Isn't it? Now, how these wise people use, how these wise people interact with the world. Wise people are there in the world or not? Don't say no. If I say no, my teacher also will become what? Ignorant. I need not go to ignorant teacher all the way. Wise people are there. Therefore, how they interact with the world? They interact with the world two ways. Two ways of interaction. He says here, laukike vaidike cha. Look into the shloka, 11th shloka. Pridhag abhasa kutasthau. They know clearly what is abhasa, reflected consciousness, and what is kutasthaha, original consciousness. Distinctly they know. Prathak means distinctly, clearly, crystal clear for them. Prathak abhasa kutasthau amukhyau. Amukhyau means two secondary meanings. Amukhyau is a dvitiya, dvivachanam. Prathama dvivachanam, amukhyau means what? Lakshyartha, gaunartha, bhagatyaga lakshana dvara. Chidabhasa, one gaunartha of jiva. Chit is another gaunartha or lakshartha of jiva. They know these two meanings clearly, without any doubt. Tatra, tatvavit, wise people, with regard to kutastha and chidabhasa, distinctly they understand. Having understood that, they interact. Paryayena, lokecha, vaidikecha, respectively. Loke means in vyavaharika routine life when they do vyavahara. Loke means what? When they do vyavahara, when they are playing their role, father role, mother role, brother role, sister role, any role for that matter, they will not roll away with the roles. Yes, they will not roll away with the roles, but they know we are playing our role. Just like a dramatist, the one who is acting on the stage must remember, I am acting. He should not forget his dialogues. He should not forget his character, what he is acting. Carefully acts. If I don't do properly, I won't get crores and crores of money. So therefore, they act very nicely. Similarly, wise person, when they interact with the world, loke chidabhasa pradhanataya prayungte aham shabdam. Aham, I am. Chidabhasena. Chidabhasa means when I do vyavahara. I am chidabhasa pradhanam. When I do vyavahara, I am chidabhasa pradhanam. Vaidike aham shabda prayungte. Vaidike means when sit in front of the teacher and studying shastra, listening to mahavakya. Aham shabda prayungte. Guru says tat tvam asi. Sishya says aham brahmasmi. When he says aham brahmasmi, that aham is kutastha chaitanyam. This wise person knows I am body, mind, RM1, RM2, RM3, Tyaga, Bhaga, Tyaga, RC1, RC2, RC3, Bhaga. RM1, RM2, RM3 means what? Sthula Shariram, RM1 means reflecting medium. Number 1, Sukshma Shariram, reflecting medium. Number 2, Karana Shariram, causal body, reflected medium. Number 3. In all these mediums, RC is reflecting. Don't take different RCs. One RC, when it is reflecting in the gross body, it is RC1. Reflecting in subtle body, it is RC2. When it is reflecting in RM3, it is RC3. Therefore, RM, RC, Tattva Bodha, LKG lesson. Really speaking, I should not explain this. Okay? Therefore, that is prathaktaya bhagatyaga. Medium here removes and say aham kutasthaha chit asmi. Aham shabda prayungte. Laukike vaidike. When you wear chappal and go into your house and interact with your family members, chidabhasa pradhana aham. You should not go and tell your husband or wife, my dear, do you know who am I? I am Kutastha Chaitanyam. If she is wise, she will ask, Amma, Kutastha Chaitanyam ki wife undodi. She will ask if she is wise. Of course, she is also not wise. That's why she will ask you, Unnake enna achi ani solluvaam. Nala, when you are interacting with your family people, chidabhasa pradhanataya. When you are claiming yourself, I am Brahman, chit pradhanata. That is called paryayena, respectively. Loke chidabhasa or abhasa, vaidike kutastha. Both are amukhya shabdartha. Amukhya aham shabda artha. Amukhya means lakshyartha. Implied meaning, secondary meaning. Two secondary meanings, one primary meaning. Primary meaning is only for ignorant people, non-Vedantic students or non-Panchadashi students. Laukike, vaidike, two secondary meanings, knowingly, deliberately, this person interacts with the people. Vyavahare chidabhasa aham. Gnate, ante gnana samaye, when I claim I am Brahman, kutastha chaitanyam, chit pradhanam. So I am very clear. Where is confusion? Then he is explaining. Up to here we saw in the last class. Now what do you mean by laukike, vaidike? Let me clarify further. Your teacher has clarified, but I want to clarify more elaborately. She has given you the summary of 12th and 13th shlokas. Now let us read the shloka, 12th shloka.
Laukikam vyavahareham. Gacchami ityadike buddhah. Vivichaiva chidabhasam. Kutasthattam vivakshati.
Now, laukike chidabhasa pradhanataya tattvavit prayunte. Now, wise person, while doing vyavahara, chidabhasa or reflected consciousness pradhanataya prayunte do vyavahara. What it means na? Laukika vyavahare. Laukika means in worldly parlance. Regular routine way of interaction. When I interact with the people or vegetable vendors or milkman or any person who are servants, drivers, whenever you come and ask auto man, can you come for Mylapore? I am Bosi, you have to come Bosi. You cannot ask. Auto person says, if you are OC also, you have to pay money. I cannot come OC. OC and free. So, that vyavahara is laukika vyavahara. You have to pay the money to him. What he says, gachami iti. Aham Mylapore gachami. Mylapore club gachami. Class gachami. I want to go to my class, which is in Mylapore, which is in Lacharchi Road. You are telling and asking auto man. That Chit Pradhana or Chidabhasa Pradhana? Chit Pradhana need not come to Mylapore. Why? It is all pervading. It is in Tamram also. It is in Mylapore also. Yes or no? Original consciousness need not travel from Tinagar to Mylapore or Thiruvanmayur to Mylapore or Tambram to Mylapore, because Kutastha Chaitanyam is all pervading. Tattvavit Jnani knows that I, the Chidabhasa, is a Vesham body mind complex. In that there is Chidabhasa, therefore I have to travel. Clear? Laukike vyavahare aham gachami. Aham kadami. I want to eat. I want to go. I want to talk. I want to speak. All these vyavahara when he is doing, vyavahare gachami iti adike. Iti adi padat, I want to speak. I want to go. I want to sit. I want to do this and that. Adi padat. All vyavahara. All kriyas. How much we are doing? Now you are sitting in the class and listening. Who is sitting? Chidabhasa is sitting or Chitti is sitting? Chidabhasa only sitting. Here I am sitting. This is a vyavahara. This is a kriya. This is a function. Function is always possible at Chidabhasa level. Clear? Function is possible always at Chidabhasa level. Buddhaha, wise people, laukika vyavahare aham gachami iti adike. Chidabhasam vivichya eva. Chidabhasam vivichya means what? By knowing clearly. Vivichya means distinctly by classifying, you know. Separately, I am now Chidabhasa, I am interacting with the world, and some students by phone, they do some interaction with Swamini. What is that Chidabhasa Pradhanam or Chitta Pradhanam? Chitta cannot do any phone call. Only Chidabhasa does phone call. Isn't it? That Chidabhasa enquires. Certain details it wants to get it enquire. That is called Vyavahara. Clear? So, Vivichya Eva Chidabhasam. Then what? Kutasthat Vivichya. Separating this Chidabhasa from Kutastha, Jnani, Buddha, wise people. Buddha means wise person. Wise person knowingly understanding that I am Chit, okay? Now I am interacting with the person. I am talking, I want to go somewhere. Now the Chidabhasa part of me, I am doing Vyavahara. That is what he says. Chidabhasam kutasthat vivichya eva vivakshati vaktum ichyati. Intending, this is not visible outside. There is no difference when Jnani says, I want to come to your house. That I is same. I want to come to your house. I want to go to so-and-so place. When that I is used in pronunciation of Ajnani and Jnani, there is no difference. Ajnani also says what? I want to come to your house. Jnani also says what? I want to come to your house. In pronunciation, in expression, there is no difference. Are you finding any difference? No. I want to come to your house. Jnani also says, I want to come to your house. When the statement, there is no change, how can you differ the Jnani and Ajnani? Vidyaranya says, the difference is in intention. Jnani says, I come to your house, I want to come to your house, that I, he intended to Chidabhasa. When Ajnani says, I want to come to your house, he doesn't know it is Chidabhasa or Chit. He doesn't know anything it is Chidabhasa or Chit or mixture. He doesn't know. Just he says, I want to come to your house. That means what? Body-mind complex only. Body only, not even mind. You know, mind absent than epome. Almost... See, ignorant people, body present, mind absent, maximum. I don't want to say all people, maximum. I am here, but I don't hear. I am here, but I don't hear. What is it? Tell me. Is it not absence of mind? Therefore, ignorant people, why they commit lot of mistakes? Because their vyavahara is so confused. Because they do not know that is Chit and Chidabhasa, mixture, they do not know. Because of that mixing up, their actions are also based up on what? Brahma. That is why confusions always. Depression, oppression, suppression, lot of things happens. Up and downs, gradations all will come. Whereas Jnani, when he says, I want to come to your house, the intention, the intended meaning of that Jnani, I want to, that I is Chidabhasa. He never mix up that Chit and Chidabhasa. He separate that Chit intellectually. Because I am originally Chit, I need not go to anyone's house because before I am going, I am there already. Chit. Always all-pervading. That is the meaning here. Vivichya kutasthat tam chidabhasam vivichya. From kutastha, original consciousness, vivichya, separating. How he separates physically or intellectually? Intellectual. Physically you can never separate. Impossible. Chidabhasa, the reflected consciousness, can never be physically separated from Chit, the original consciousness. Vivakshati, that is vivakshati means intended. It is his intention. He alone or she alone knows, Jnani alone knows that when I am talking laukika vyavahare, is it chidabhasa or chit? He knows or she knows. Clear? Now come to Vaidike, how he interacts, intention. Now this is laukika. Clear? When you are coming to the class and you are telling to the family members, na class poittu varen, I go to class and come back. Chidabhasa or chit intention you have. Without knowing, you are telling previously. Now tomorrow onwards, what you are going to, your intention is class ku poittu varenna chidabhasa part of aham class ku poittu varen. Correct? Am I correct? Tomorrow onwards you do that way only, no? But don't tell others. When I am telling to you from my chidabhasa standpoint, I am telling to, don't confuse others. Okay? What you have confused previously and you are confusing now, keep with yourself and clarify yourself more and more. Get knowledge. Don't bother about others' struggle, others' ignorance. First you correct yourself. Human being problem enna theriyumo, even vidumbodu avanna pull pattu. So, don't confuse others. Where they are, let them. They see, if they are hungry, they have to eat. You cannot eat for them. If they are thirsty, they have to drink water. You cannot drink for them. Similarly, this knowledge is also like that. They have to understand. You cannot just like that and make abrupt statements and confusing people. They will... what? Banish you. No, intellectually. They will banish you. Don't get such a status, okay? Don't be banished by others because of over attachment, over love and affection. Don't communicate all these words to non-scriptural persons. He may be dear to you or she may be dear to you. But never do that. Okay. Mannuda bhayam. Otherwise, there is a problem in the house. Therefore, Vedantic students have to handle the family interactions very carefully. Now, 13th shloka.
Asangoham chidatmaham. इति शास्त्रीय दृष्टितः अहम् शब्दम् प्रयुङ्क्तेयम् कूटस्थे केवले बुधः
Wise person, when he or she is interacting with the family members and the society, with the knowledge, deliberately they interact. Chidabhasa, kevala chidabhasa. Even though chit is there, even though chit, original consciousness is there always, when I am chidabhasa pradhana in laukika vyavahara, kevala chidabhasa, I am intended. Isn't it? Kevala chidabhasa, I am intended. When guru is talking, you are asangaha. You are not touched by anything really. You are pure consciousness. When guru says, asangahatvam, asangahatvam, the Sishya has to say, asangaha aham. I am unattached. I am not touched by anything. That asangatvam. He is looking to the shloka. Buddhaha, wise person. Wise person. Asangaha aham iti. Chidatmaham iti. Asangoham chidatmaham iti. Chidatma means I am pure consciousness. Chit eva atma chidatma. I am pure consciousness. What do you mean by atma? Atma definition, do you remember? Yadapnoti, yadadatte, yachyapti vishayaniha, yachyasya santato bhavaha, tasmat atma iti uchyate. Atma is that which is all pervading. Yadapnoti, yadadatte, that which experience everything. Yachyapti vishayaniha, yadadatte means that which grasp everything. Yachyapti vishayaniha means that which experience every object. Yad apnoti iti atma. Apnoti iti atma. Atti iti atma. Adatte iti atma. Santataha bhavaha atma. All the time it is there. Santataha bhavaha. Yachyasya santato bhavaha. Yasya santataha bhavaha means always it is existent. Always it is existent. Existence principle. Santataha bhavaha. Tasmat atma iti uchyate. Therefore it is known as atma. So what is that atma? Chit. Chit alone is atma. That which is all pervading, that which grasps everything, that which experience objects, that which is always in three periods of time experience, three periods of time existing, that is called Atma, Chidatma. Aham Chidatma, Aham Asangaha. That Aham, I, Aham is equal to I. I means not this I. I am, non. That I, aham, chidatma, therefore aham asangaha. I am of the higher order of reality. Chidabhasa is of lower order of reality. Vyavaharika satta. Aham chidatma paramarthika satta. Therefore, vyavaharika satta, paramarthika satta cannot come across. They cannot come across. Therefore, aham asangaha. Example you have to remember immediately. Vekar. Vekar is vyavaharika satta. Dreamer is pratibhasika satta. Projected reality. This vekar is relative reality. Relative reality and projected reality cannot be contacted. Asangaha. Like that, Vekar, this Chidabhasa, Pramata, is Vyavaharika Satyam. Chidatma, Aham, Kutastha Chaitanyam is Paramarthika Satyam, higher order of reality. Therefore, Aham Asangaha. Just as dream water cannot make your body wet, dream fire cannot make your body burnt. Similarly, this body cannot touch me, Vekar body cannot touch me, the Chidatma, because I am higher order of reality. Therefore, Shastriya Drishtitaha. Shastriya Drishti means what? When the student is studying in the class, Guru says, you are Brahman, you are Asangaha, you are the pure consciousness. When he says Guru, Shishya has to say, yes Guru, I am Chit, I am that Chidatma, I am Asangaha. Shastriya Drishti. Clear? That Drishti is previous one is Vyavaharika Drishti, Laukika Drishti. So student has got now two Drishtis. When we are sitting in the class, using the Chidabhasa and writing the notes, but claiming yourself as Chidatma Asangaha Aham. How you have got that drishti, that word are you able to say? Because of Shastra. From the Shastra drishti, I have received Shastric teaching. Because of that jnanam, from that angle, I am Kutastha Chaitanyam Chidatma. Now, are you able to say boldly, Aham Kutastha Chaitanyam? Yes, very good. Aham Shabdam Prayunte. Now, this aham, I am, the word is used. What is the intention of that Jnani, wise person Buddha, wise person intention when he says, Aham Asangaha. When he says, I am unattached, I am detached, I am not touched by anything, when we say that, from Chidabhasa angle, I cannot say that. From mixture angle also, I cannot say that. From Kutastha angle only, I can say that. Kutastha Chaitanya. So the Jiva, even though it is a mixture, from Kutastha angle, I am Aham Shabdam Prayunte, I use that. Now, next, this much of clarity you won't get anywhere. That is why Prakarana Grandha study is very, very important. Bhagavad Gita, Upanishad and all, you won't get there, here. But Bhagavad Gita has got unique teaching. Upanishad also has got its own unique teaching. Okay? Aham Shabdam Prayungte. Ayam Kutasthe Kevale Buddha. Ayam, this is Makarantaha, Idam Shabdaha. Aham Asmi Iti Ityasya Karta. Ayam, that I am word he is using from the main statement. Atmanam chet vijanityat ayam asmiti purushah. I am atma aham asmiti. That I am atma aham asangaha asmi. So aham shabdam prayungte. I am kutasthe kevale kutasthe. Kevala kutastha means what? That Chidabhasa is there. Otherwise, he cannot say, I am Kutastha Chaitanyam. Pure Kutastha Chaitanyam cannot say, I am Kutastha Chaitanyam. Because Nirvikaratvat. Isn't it? Now the question is going to come that later. Now Shastriya Drishtya, Aham Asangaha, Asangaha means Kevala Chit. Chit Pradhanata, Chit Drishtya, Kevala Kutastha Drishya, Drishtya Aham Asangaham. Now, next shloka. Pura Pakshi is coming. One person is asking a question. Now it is very clear. Now I have understood Laukike, Vaidike, and mixture. Primary meaning, Amukhyartha, two meanings. It is very clear. You are a good teacher, I accept. No. அவர் என்ன கேட்குற போறார் தெரியுமா? நவ் ஹூ இஸ் கிளைமிங் ஐ ஆம் பிரம்மன்? ஹூ இஸ் கிளைமிங் ஐ ஆம் பிரம்மன்? அஹம் கூட்டஸ்தா அஸ்மி, அஹம் சிதாத்மா அசங்கா அஸ்மி. ஹூ இஸ் கிளைமிங்? பூர்வபக்ஷி இஸ் ஆஸ்கிங் க்வெஸ்சன். 14th ஸ்லோக வில் ரீட். ஜ்ஞானிதா ஜ்ஞானிதே
भासस्यैव न चात्मनः तथा च कथमाभासः कूटस्थोऽस्मीति बुध्यताम्.
नौ दि पूर्वपक्षी इज आस्किंग. Upanishad says, one should know oneself. Atmanam chet vijaniyat. That is the statement, first shloka. One should know one's atmaswarupam. Commandment. This is called commandment. This Upanishadic commandment, referring to whom now? One should know his or her Atman nature. Upanishad telling to someone. Isn't it? One person. One should know. Now you are telling Kutastha Chaitanyam and Chidabhasa. Aham meaning has got two meanings here. Aham, three meanings are there. Now mixture, you are telling ignorant people. Okay, leave all ignorant people. You are also intelligent, no? He is coming and sitting here and asking all of you. You are pushing away all ignorant people who are all talking with mixture. Okay, let them be there. You are all thinking you are all intelligent people. and you are all claiming aham brahmasmi, and you all said that you laukike chidabhasam vyavahara pradhanam and shastriya drishtya chit pradhanam alla irukatam, let it be there, it's very nice to listen. Now tell me, clarify me, who is claiming aham kutasthaha asmi? Tell me. Siddhabhasa claiming or Chitta claiming? He is ready already. He is having answer. Purapakshi. What is his answer? No? Siddhabhasa cannot claim. Why? Siddhabhasa cannot be the kutastha. All pervading kutastha. Siddhabhasa cannot be the all pervading kutastha. Therefore, Siddhabhasa can say, I am kutasthaha. Siddhabhasa cannot say, it is brahmajnanam. Chidabhasa claims aham brahmasmi, it is a brahmajnanam. You, the Chidabhasa limited fellow, samsari, how can you say aham kotasthaha? If suppose Chidabhasa says I am kotasthaha, it is a brahmajnanam. No, Chidabhasana irundindi, nan kotasthan kotasthan in cholla mudiyuma? Chidabhasa cannot say, because it is limited. Chidabhasa can never be chit. Therefore, Chidabhasa cannot claim, I am Chit Kutasthaha. Ruled out. Now, can Kutastha claim, Aham Kutasthaha? Kutastha also cannot claim Nirvikaratvat. To say Aham Kutastha, it is a function. It is a words you have to utter. There is a vikara, there is a modification. You, Kutastha cannot utter that word, Kutastha cannot claim Nirvikaratvat. So both are ruled out. Chidabhasa cannot claim Aham Kutastha. Kutastha cannot claim Aham Kutastha. Then who is claiming Aham Kutastha Chit Atma Asmi? Tell me, who can claim? Now tell me, he is asking question. That is the question. Now let us look into the sloka. Jnanita Ajnanite. Here, Jnanita Ajnanita means, see, the Chidabhasa is the knower. Chidabhasa is the knower. Chidabhasa is the doer. Chidabhasa is the ego. Okay? That is the Pramata, that is the Karta, that is the Ahankara. Chidabhasa. This Chidabhasa, Upanishad said what? One should know. One should know. Vijaniyat. The knower is who? Kutastha cannot be the knower. If Chidabhasa is the knower, Chidabhasa is the knower, but its Chidabhasa cannot claim Aham Kutastha. Chidabhasa is the knower. Even though it is a knower, it cannot know I am, even it knows I am, it is Kutastha is there. Suppose, are you all here? Here means very meaning, not H-E-R-E. All of you are hearing, all of you are hearing, Chidabhasa, suppose, knows aham, see, I have Kutastha Chaitanyam as Adharam. That Chidabhasa can know as a knower. If at all it knows, I have Chitta Atma as a knower. As a knower, as my Adhara, Adhishtanam, which is free, Asamsari, that much Chidabhasa can know as a knower. But Chidabhasa can never say, I am Kutastha. That is what my point, Purapakshi asks. Chidabhasa is the knower. Upanishad says one should know. One should know means that must person must be the knower. The knower must be the Chidabhasa. The Chidabhasa is the knower. Knower of Kutastha. Okay, that is also possible. It is the knower of Kutastha. Kutastha is pure Atma. Kutastha is Adharam. Kutastha is Adhishtanam. Kutastha is Asamsari. Kutastha is always free. That much Chidabhasa can know. This Pramata Ahankara can know. But this Chidabhasa Ahankara, one thing it cannot do. Aham Kutasthaha it cannot say. Impossible. That's what he says. Jnanita Ajnanite. ज्ञानित्वम अज्ञानित्वम द स्टेटस ऑफ नॉलेज द स्टेटस ऑफ इग्नोरेंस नोवरहुड एंड नॉन नोवरहुड ज्ञानिता मीन्स नोवरहुड अज्ञानिता मीन्स नॉन नोवरहुड आई नो आई डोंट नो आई नो इज कॉल्ड नोवरहुड आई डोंट नो इज कॉल्ड नॉन नोवरहुड क्लियर ज्ञानिता अज्ञानिते द्वंद्व समास तु आत्माभासस्य एव नोवरहुड एंड नॉन नोवरहुड बोथ आर पॉसिबल ईदर आई कैन नो दिस इज अ फ्लवर आई डू नॉट नो दिस फ्लवर बोथ कैन हैपन इन चिदाभास आत्माभास मीन्स हियर चिदाभास आत्मा हैपन्स टू बी चित चितः आभासः और आत्मनः आभासः आत्माभासः चिदाभासः चिदाभासस्य एव इट इज पॉसिबल न आत्मनः नॉट चित नॉट कूटस्थ चैतन्यम तथा च तस्मात् तथा च मीन्स तस्मात् देयरफॉर कथम आभासः कथम हाउ दिस आभास रिफ्लेक्टिंग consciousness chidabhasa abhasaha means chidabhasa or pramata the knower kutastaha asmi aham asmi iti aham understood that is in within inverted commas kutastaha aham asmi iti that part portion matram within inverted commas kutastaha aham asmi iti budhyatam how chidabhasa can claim aham kutasthaha it is not possible it can know about kutastha it can glorify the kutastha but the knower can be only as a separate entity as a third person it can know not as a first person aham asmi it cannot say kutasthaha asti it can say that's what people are saying no atma asti Atma is there, Atma is there. Now Shastra is telling what? Atma I am, Atma Asmi, Aham Asmi, first person. You have to say first person. If Atma Asti Asti says, enak enna prayojana? Dhanam Asti Asti inna. money is there and enna prayojana? My pocket is empty, suppose. My pocket is empty, what is the use? Therefore, people talking about Atma is there, wonderful Atma, Atma is great, Brahman is so great. I am sufferer, I am suffering, anna enna prayojana anna. Adi madri, Atma asti asti says, Upanishad is asking, I am asmi iti purushaha, asmi, first person lo jolano. Purapakshi says, adi mudiyadu, nanu samsari da. ఎప్పుమే ఐ ఆమ్ సంసారి ఓన్లీ ఐఎమ్ చిదాభాసందా చిదాభాసన సఫరింగ్ ఆయండే ఇక నా ఎప్పుడు కూటస్థన అసంసారి ఆహ ముడియం ముడియాదప్ప అని చెల్లారు పూర్వపక్షి విద్యారణ్య సేస్ ముడియం హూ సేసనా చిదాభాస ఎలోన్ హీఈస్ గోయింగ్ టు గివ్ ఆన్సర్ హౌ ఈస్ ఇట్ పాసిబుల్ ఐ విల్ టెల్ యూ నా Now he says, Tadhache katham avasaha kutastaha aham asmi. Asmi, Uttama Purusha eka vachanam. Asmi. Asti I can say. That's all people can say, no? Atma asti, asti. Hey, Atma asti illa. You are the Atma. Adi the problem, Swamini. I am sufferer. How can I be free Atman? That's why people are not having courage to say, అహం ఆత్మా అస్మి పీపుల్ కెన్ బోల్డ్లీ సే అండ్ స్టడీ అకాడమికల్లీ ఇయర్స్ టుగెదర్ అండ్ సే హే ఆత్మా సత్తు చిత్తు ఆనంద దే టాక్ అండ్ అవర్స్ టుగెదర్ బట్ వెరీ రేర్లీ పీపుల్ హ్యావ్ కరేజ్ టు సే టు అహం బ్రహ్మాస్మి కరేజ్ టు సే మీన్స్ వాట్ క్లారిటీ అండర్స్టాండింగ్ టు సే నాట్ కరేజ్ అన్న బోల్డ్నెస్ క్లారిటీ అండర్స్టాండింగ్ You require tremendous subtle intellect for that. Grasping mind. Okay, not possible. Katham buddhyatam. How is it? Buddhyatam is a lot. Pratham purusha ekavachanam buddhudhatu 4a. It is an active voice only, not passive voice. Buddhyatam. How Chidabhasa claim, aham kutasthaha asmi, it is not possible. Now Vidyaranya's answer. 15th shloka.
Nayam doshos chidabhasaham. Kutasthaikasvabhavavan. Abhasatvasya mithyatvat. Kutasthatvavasheshanat.
This Chidabhasa Chit introduction, what purpose, you know, really speaking, go on talking Chittu, Chidabhasa, Chittu, Chidabhasa, RCOC, RCOC. Why we introduce this? Like certain medicines, to cure the disease, we give medicines. Doctors give us medicine. Sometimes when they are using those medicines for curing disease, they get some side effects also. Definitely side effects. Burning sensation inside because of antibiotics. Naturally side effects comes. Like that, this Chitta and Chidabhasa division is for teaching purpose. Why people ask? Since people ask that soul may, let the soul be in peace. After death, no, condolence and all, people say, let the soul be in peace. You know, one is the soul, S-O-U-L, not S-O-L-E, okay. S-O-U-L, soul, may be in peace. And let it go without any problem. Which is that soul? Travel. Atma travels, they say. Astityeke, nayam astityeke. People ask, Nachiketa asked, Yamadharma Raja, some people say that something is traveling after death. Who is that traveling? Then some people say this Jivatma is merging with Ishvara. Who is that merging? Tell me. Since they are asking, therefore Upanishad divide for the sake of teaching purpose. Who travels in the Chidabhasa travels? Now easily we can say, because you are all clear, Chidabhasa Chit. Who travels after death? Chit is all pervading. Chit need not travel. Chit cannot travel. Chidabhasa travels. Job is over. Then who is merging with Ishwarana? The Chidabhasa Pradvimba Chaitanyam Sariratraya Pradvimba Chaitanyam merges with Prapanchatraya Pradvimba Chaitanyam in Ishwara. Over. No problem. This is very nice to give answer for people who ask. But there is a problem. Dayananda Swamiji says always, if you go on teaching Chit Chidabhasa, people definitely separate both of them. They are two entities they will take. You long time don't teach Chit Chidabhasa, carefully, immediately bring them into both are one and the same. Now for merging purpose, for traveling purpose, only teaching purpose we have given that for Vyavahara sake. Really speaking, Chidabhasa is mithya, mithyatvat. Look into the shloka. Ayam na doshaha. There is no dosha. Why? Chidabhasa cannot claim Chidabhasa is the knower. It can only say kutastaha asti, not asmi. He cannot say you are telling. Chidabhasa says aham kutastaha asmi. There is nothing wrong. Doshaha nasti. There is no dosha. When Chidabhasaha kutastaha ekatva ekasvabhavavan. Kutasthaha. Kutavatu tishtati iti kutasthaha. Kutasthaha svabhavavan. Svabhavavan means here the content. Chidabhasa is nothing. The content of Chidabhasa is chit. Kutastaha eva. Chidabhasaha substantiality is chit. Now you take the golden chain and show what is the content of this golden chain? Gold. Now what is the content of this Chidabhasa? Chit. Where is Chidabhasa? Why you are, that's why problem when we teach you should not take Chidabhasa is somewhere, Chitti is somewhere, both are different. Never take like that. There is no Chidabhasa other than Chit. There is no Chidabhasa separately other than Chit. Chit alone appearing as Chidabhasa, like a mask. Chit is wearing the Chidabhasa mask. Okay, that Chidabhasa mask is only for Vyavahara. Now look into the shloka. Kutastha ekat ekasvabhavavan. Chidabhasaha kutasthaha ekasvabhavavan. Both are one and the same. One swarupam. Abhasaha tu asya mithyatmat. This abhasa, what reflected consciousness you are talking, it is just only a lip movement. Abhasaha is a mithya. Mithya means vyavaharikam ityarthaha. Mithyatvat kutasthatva avasheshanat. Kutasthatva kutavatu tishthati iti kutasthaha tasya bhavaha kutasthatvam tasya avasheshanam kutasthatva avasheshanam tasmat kutasthatvavaseshanat. Appa, kutastha only remains. How real your reflected face in the mirror? You count separately? Your reflected face in the mirror, can you count separately? How many faces are there? Swamini, four mirrors, four reflected faces. And this face, totally five. Enna? Five? Five or one? One. Similarly, so many reflected consciousnesses are there, so many Chidabhasas are there, so many knowers are there, all of them are mithya, vyavaharikam, uncountable, you cannot count them. Who remains? Kotastha eva avaseshana. This is not countable. Innu puriyalana, next shloka na solra eppadi an example kudukkarar. He gives the example. Next shloka, that is 16th shloka, next page we will read. Kutastho smiti bodhopi. Mithya chenneti ko vadet. Nahi satyataya bhishtam. Rajju sarpami sarpanam. Now Pura Pakshi is asking, you are telling Chidabhasa only claiming aham kutastha asmi. No dosha you are telling. And you said in second line Chidabhasaha mithya, unreal. That Chidabhasa is unreal and its knowledge I am kutastha is also must be unreal. Is asking. What is the first line? Kutastaha aham asmi iti bodhaha. Chidabhasa only getting aham brahma asmi knowledge, aham kutastaha asmi. Now you are telling kutastha aham asmi knowledge is coming in Chidabhasa and Chidabhasa is mithya, you are telling. Appo in the jnanam kuda mithya dane. Aham kutastaha asmi, which knowledge comes in unreal Chidabhasa. Unreal Chidabhasa knowledge must be unreal or real? Must be unreal. Tell me, can you accept that? He's asking us. Vidyaranya says, happily, I'll accept. Who said it is real? Bodhaha also unreal. Kaha vadet na iti. Who said it is not? Who said it is not kutastaha aham asmi, this bodhaha? Who said it is not mithya? I am telling it is also mithya. Why? Since Chidabhasa is mithya, that knowledge which comes in Chidabhasa is also mithya. Then liberation is also mithya. Who said it is real? He is telling, nahi satyataya bhishtam. We never want that aham kutastaha asmi jnanam is a vritti. It is a vikara, it is a vritti vyapara, it is a function, it is an attribute. It happens only in Chidabhasa. That is also mithya. Jnana vritti is also mithya. Therefore, we don't want it to be a satyam. It cannot be satyam, it need not be satyam. Yena, eppadina, rajju sarpa visarpanam. Rajjau sarpaha, rajjau kalpita sarpaha. Rajju sarpaha. Okay, saptami tat, purusha samasa. Rajju kalpita sarpa visarpanam. You are seeing a rope snake, our number snake, okay. That snake you have seen upon the rope. After seeing the snake upon the rope, and you are talking about the movement of the rope. How much real the movement of the rope? Visarpana means visruppudhata. Srupp means to crawl. That goes in a zigzag way. Visarpana means movement of the sarpa is real. Once the sarpa is unreal, movement of the sarpa also must be unreal. Similarly, chidabhasa is unreal. Chidabhasanla, that pramata chidabhasanla, when the aham kutasthaha asmi is also, that jnanam also unreal. Why I have to come to Panchadashi class then? But come to the next class, okay? You have to come. Purnamada purnamidam purnat purnamudachyate purnasya purnamadaya purnameva vasishyate. Om shanti shanti shantih harihi om. Shri Gurubhyo namaha harihi om.